So now that you know about Boolean formulas, so what is the SAT problem? The SAT problem has as an input a Boolean formula with n variables, and I'm usually going to write them as x1, x2, and so on until you get to xn. And the output or question, since SAT is a decision problem, is the following. And the question is, can you set the variables x1 to xn to a combination of true or false so that the whole formula that you're given in the input becomes true? And the answer to that can, of course, only be yes or no. So again, SAT is a decision problem. So for example, if we're given a very simple Boolean formula such as x1 and x2, then the answer to SAT would be yes, because you could set x1 to true and x2 to true, and then the whole formula would also evaluate to true, because you have 1 and 1, which is true, or 1. Let's do a little bit more challenging example. If you had a Boolean formula such as this, x1 and x2, or x1 and not x1, or x2. And what you can also see here is that you do not always have to put brackets around each or to signify in which order you evaluate the individual ones. So it's okay to write 2 or 3 or 4 ors, or 2 or 3 or 4 ands, or even more if you want to, without doing those brackets. It doesn't really make a difference in the way that the formula evaluates. But let's come back to SAT. So does this Boolean formula here have a satisfying assignment? Meaning, can you set the variables to a combination of true and false so that the whole formula becomes true? And here the answer is again yes. X1, unfortunately, doesn't really help here. So if you set x1 to true, for example, this would also be true. And here you have not x1. So x1 and not x1, that would evaluate to 0. If you set x1 to 0, then you have it the other way around. And then let's set x2 to 1, because then this whole thing here is 1. This stays at 0 no matter what we do. And this one also goes to 1. And then you have 1 or 0 or 1. So there's at least 1 in here. And so the whole thing evaluates to 1. And the formula can be satisfied. So now let's see if you can figure out an even more challenging example yourself. So here's our Boolean formula, x1 or x3, and x1 and x2 or not x3. And the formula continues here, not x2 or not x3. And not x1 or not x2. And I'm going to reveal to you that this formula indeed has an assignment of true and false to the variables x1, x2, and x3, so that the whole formula is satisfied, meaning it evaluates to true. What I want to know from you is how I have to set the variables to do this. So if I should set x1 to false, please check here. If I should set it to true, please check here. And the same thing for the variables x2 and x3, please.